Hi, Mark Vergeer here. Some people have asked me how I do my video grabbing solution on the PC, where I have footage of consoles or computers playing and I have at the same time video going on. I actually do that on a single computer. You can also use more multiple cameras and just sync up the footage in a video editing program, but you can actually do it with one computer. And I'll show you how. First, let me show you a schematic on how I connect up all my consoles. Basically, these are all my older consoles, and they either connect up over RF, composite, S video, RGB, S video, oh yeah, of course, HDMI. So modern consoles, older consoles, the HDMI and component, I've got a switch for that. And that switch is actually located down below. So that goes directly into the TV. RGB is connected over a SCART box, which is also connected into the TV. S video also goes into a SCART box, composite goes into a SCART box, and RF goes directly into the TV. Okay, and now someone is trying to chat me. VK, are you still in France? Well, I'm trying to make a video. Oh God. Okay. So, hi VK. I'm gonna have to respond to you a bit later. But these are all my consoles. This is my TV. And everything is hooked up over SCART boxes. Those SCART boxes are actually visible over there. These two SCART boxes, three actually. So how do they connect up? Well, SCART box has inputs as video, RGB, as video, composite, and it has a lead to the TV, RGB out, but it also has an ability to have another one out. So actually you have a video out, video in, and it goes two ways, one to the TV. A small diagram. This is actually a small diagram. So this is my video grabbing solution, and actually the center of it is actually two SCART switch boxes. They are interlinked, so and that's just to have more inputs. The SCART boxes, the secret to it is actually a Y solution, where an incoming signal is doubled into two outgoing signals. That's basically what the premise of this successful grabbing actually consists of. I've got a regular LCD TV, which is over there, and hooked up to it are various consoles, like the Xbox, which is over HDMI. There's a PlayStation 2, which is connected over a component. There's a PlayStation 3, which is also connected over HDMI or component. And I've actually got a component switch, similar to the SCART switch box, which is actually located over here. This one. That's the component switch box. To the SCART boxes, I've connected a whole series of consoles, but you can also have DVD players and digital TV tuners connected, like I've done over here. I've connected a Pioneer DVD player, and on top of it I've connected a Humax digital TV scanner. So all these consoles, they connect either over S-Video, RGB, SCART, or composite, and some of them components. One of these old Xboxes, actually the American one, hooks up over a component, so I can't grab component, I can't grab HDMI, nor can I grab VGA, but I can grab S-Video, Composite, SCART, RGB. So how do I grab it? Well, this basically is the control center in which I just select which source the signal outputs on the TV. I can just put the TV on SCART and it'll just play everything that comes over in this system. And this this signal over here, it can either be RGB, composite, or S-Video. So all these two boxes, they can have all these signals. They're slightly different, so... Okay, whenever I want to grab some footage or use my old CRT TV, I enable this system to output the signal that comes in here over to this TV. This is a Y solution. There goes a signal directly into the TV, and there's another signal going directly into either a Dazzle PVC 170 USB grabbing solution or a Pinnacle PCI TV card. Both are standard definition video grabbing solutions that either use software codecs, lossless video encoding, or use hardware encoding. But there's always lag. When the PC gets a signal that comes into it, there's always lag before it displays it onto the monitor. So people who have been directly connecting their consoles over the Dazzle or the Pinnacle, they always will experience lag, because grabbing software, much like modern TVs, actually use a lot of software routines to clear up the picture, process the picture and stuff. And actually, some of the LCD TVs, they have a special game mode that allows the signal to travel quickly from the input to what's visible on the screen, because it can almost be up to half a second in some, you know, when you put digital noise reduction on and whatever processing video modes that the TVs, modern TVs, are capable of. And of course, when you press a button on the controller of the console, you want to have the response on the video as quickly as possible. Well, these analog solutions using small cables, they will hardly take any processing time. They just don't. It's just like a regular cable. The only thing is, when you hook up all these connectors, of course there's going to be signal loss. These boxes that I have, I'll show you the brand that I'm using. They are AC powered, and they have they actually enhance the quality, so they amplify the signal quality. So, but if you use a lot of these switch boxes in series, well, of course you're gonna get a degrading signal. But I actually prefer these power boxes. Of course, you can also hook up a non-powered one, which I have over here. That is just your regular multiple SCART in, and this actually has nice buttons that you can press to just select one of the inputs, because there's also these multi SCART boxes that just have all of these working at the same time, and which of course can cause some problems. The SCART signal, of course, uses a special voltage, and these powered SCART switch boxes, they will provide the proper voltage for the TV to select, you know, to jump to the right in the right mode. So there's this. But if you use these non-powered solutions, you can have voltage problems. So, and it's not very good for your systems, I think. Anyways, software that I'm using to process the video is Descaler, And descaler, that is excellent for use with the PCI TV cards that you have in your, that you can have in your computer system, if the descaler, which sadly isn't developed anymore, is compatible with your TV card, the chipset on it. It actually is able to process the signal hardly without any lags. This enables you, with that Dazzle, you can actually hook up a console directly to the PC and use the monitor, the monitor to output the gameplay. And because there's very little lag, it's doable to play and record directly. But it's only possible with Dazzle. Pinnacle Studio HD number 14 I'm using, and I also have Sony Vegas. That kind of software really can grab footage, but it's always at a lag. Pinnacle Studio HD number 14 works perfectly together with the Dazzle PVC 170 USB grabbing solution, because this little card has hardware grabbing, and it produces very nice MP4 files that aren't too big but are of a very nice quality. So I think I'm gonna scan this page in, and I'm just gonna put it up on my www.markvergeer.nl website, so you guys can take a look at it. I'll put the link probably in the description below. So let me show you some of the I want to show you the Dazzle, and I want to show you one of these SCART boxes that I've been using. So this is the SCART box, which is also I've also got one over here. And it's not the best, but I don't want to unhook it. It's the Vivanco control system, and the model is the SBX95SE AV Control Deck 4, and you can have it set to auto select or manual. Auto select, it just selects any device that is connected over one of these. If it detects a signal, it just jumps to it. If you put it to manual and you just press that button, this is an in but also an out, so you can hook up a daisy chain, another one of these systems. It has another one on the front as video, composite, and the audio on the back is SCART connectors, and with special adapters you can actually get the S video signal in there, composite as well. So that's the Vivanco. Let's show you guys the Dazzle. The Dazzle is one of these USB solutions. This lead goes to an USB. The Dazzle, and on the front it has S video in, which I'm not using at the moment, composite and stereo audio. And the Dazzle system that I'm actually using is the DVC 170 revision 1.2, and actually works like a charm. And that way I'm able to grab and operate and have the game playing on multiple systems. What I do when I do the gameplay, when I do the gameplay and the and the footage recording simultaneously, what you can actually do is use another camera pointed at you, recording your software and then aligning the video files grabbed here and grabbed by the external camera in your video editing software. Or you can do what I do, because I use a USB webcam to actually narrate and use that to record my face and what I do simultaneously with grabbing the footage. And I'm able to do that because this computer has a dual core processor, and because of the Dazzle DVC 170 using hardware video encoding. So the PC uses most of its processing power to grab footage of the digital camera, the webcam that I use, and I just use click rec in the program that uses the webcam, and I click rec on the Dazzle in this Studio HD, Pinnacle Studio HD. So I'm actually recording both files simultaneously. I can also use this camera, set it up, and the good thing about syncing up both video videos is actually to have something happen on both signals at the same time, so you can use that to align the video, and it's very, very easy to do something like that. So I'm gonna scan in this piece of drawing, and hopefully you guys will be able to make heads or tails out of it. How do you say that? Oh my god, proverbs. I'm very bad at proverbs, but yeah, hopefully you guys will be able to do something with this little skin. Yeah, the main thing is have one input signal, yeah, double. Some people are actually using just regular video cables directly on the console that they spliced. So you got the for example the composite signal goes into the TV and that goes into the PC, so you don't have the lag because that's going up to the TV and that's going to the PC. So you can actually, if you just don't want to use all these, you just want to splice your AV cables, and you can actually get these things with a connector that you use, and you'll have like so. Whoops. Okay, so this is the original, for example, the composite yellow connector that comes out of, you know, your AV lead of your console, your system, and you just buy one of these things that actually inputs, and then you just have two wires, one going to a jack and the other one going to a jack. This one goes to the TV and that, and this one goes to a recorder. So some old TVs with a double SCART connector actually have this built into it, but it's always CRT TVs. And what that does, what that enables you, if you just connect up a console directly to the TV, you can have one of the SCART connectors output to a recorder. So you can have direct gameplay and just use record over your TV. Back in the day, people would do that with their video recorders. If the video was recorded, video recorder was connected over SCART, and SCART can actually be two ways. SCART can be in and out if you use all the wires in the connectors. And most TVs just have multiple SCART connectors. The one is actually used for VCR functionality. It has in and out, and the other one is just in. So that's also a way of circumventing this whole thing. Just use your TV as the Y signal. You just record from the SCART out. A lot of TVs, older TVs, and this TV actually allows it as well. And that TV that have multiple SCART connectors, that actually offer that functionality as well. I'm actually using the second SCART connector here to go to the. You can also get to the PC. You can also get little blocks that you stick a SCART cable into, and it just passes through, and you have another connector where you can plug in another SCART cable. So you actually create a Y signal solution that way as well. Well, that's me talking for 17-18 minutes about my video grabbing solutions. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if not, well, I'm sorry. And Mark is signing off, and I'll be back with another video soon.